Hi, welcome to another art journal page. Today I'll be using rice paper from Marimee Small Art, The Roses, and the lady is from Stamperia. And I'm first adding water around the lady so I can tear off the parts that I don't want to use for now. Then I still want to use the roses, so I'll be using them on the side. And since I want to do two pages, I'm taking some roses from another rice paper sheet, placing them on the other side to make it look like one whole. I'm just placing them now, not adhering them, because I first want to see the layout. On how it looks like. Then I'm using modeling paste. No, I'm sorry. Matgel medium. I'm using matgel medium to adhere all my rice paper. And I'm using a pass credit bank card to smoothen it out. And then the same thing on the other side. It's going to be a fairly easy page because there's no drawing of yourself, it's just rice paste papers. I'm going over the lady because later, I want to be using some paint, so I want to de-resist there. Start placing a rose on the right side. And then my roses are finished on my paper. It's only closed roses. And I don't want to use the closed roses, so after drying everything, be looking at my sentiment where I want it. It's a postcard. I'm gonna cut it out. Also gonna place it on my paper in the middle, on the other, on the left side of my paper, in the middle. And then I'm still tearing out a rose for under in the corner on the left side. It was a big rose. Also, so adhering it with modeling paste. And then I'm adhering my sentiment. I have to put a little more of the modeling paste because the paper is thick, it's like cardstock. And then I'm ready to use my stencil with roses and some modeling paste because the plate above her head to the other side of the rose. I still wanted some more roses. So that is what I'm going to place with the modeling paste. But first, I have this, don't know how you call those things, but they make a nice edge. And that's what I used on the side. I think they're called edge pawns. We don't see it really well here, but when I use the back of the paper and there's color under, then you will see it. So now I'm ready to use my modeling paste. I'm using my homemade modeling paste because it's thicker than the one I have. And I just want to use the roses, not the leaves, but the roses. And I have to dry in between, otherwise the stencil will mess it up. It's just so the pages get connected. I'm only placing them on the left side and up to connect the pages. I don't want to use them down. Then I'm drying the modeling paste in between so I can use my ink. And it's going to be a blue page because I'm using a whole lot of blue shades. Didn't want to use any other colors but blue, so that's what I'm doing here. And I'm first gonna color the girl. This is a nail color too. I'm giving her skin color. To make it look more realistic. That's why I didn't want to cut a color under my rice paper before I place them. Using dilutions ink. I'm diluting it with water. You can see the color was very dark, so because dilution ink will react with water, I just keep watering down my first two to color the rest. And then I'm more in the scheme, color scheme that I want. And once I've colored them, I have to dry it in between. I'll be using some shimmer. Giving her some red lips, some cheeks, pink cheeks. Some eyeshadow and some brown hair. Doing this with my Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pens. Because those ones, they are also reacting with water, but once they have been dried, they don't move anymore. So, placing some shadows. Taking three colors of blue. Giving her a blue eyeshadow. And then I'm gonna use it for my flowers because it also reacts on water, so to be using it also for shadows. I'll first place the color with a pit pen, and I move it with my water brush, or my watered brush. It gives it a little bit more of depth, so it will look a little bit more realistic. And then I was thinking, okay, how am I going to color the page? Because at first I was thinking I would just use one color, shade of blue. But I was thinking I will use my gel press. So I'm using the same ink for the flowers, and I water it down, and then just put it like that directly on my paper. And the color, the shimmer color, and is the same name. So I have one without shimmer and one with shimmer. I'm just placing the spots here, there, everywhere. Just wanted to look a little bit the same like the dress, the under part from the dress. So that's what I'm doing now to make it a whole. And actually, it doesn't look bad, I think. I've got a little blue spot on the face there, so I have to take it off. But this is all I'm doing now to make the page look nice. I'm adding the shimmer. I don't want too much shimmer, but a little bit. So that's what I'm adding now. Same technique. I'm putting it on my jelly plate and water it down, and then in between. And I wanted to look my text. I wanted my text to stand out a little bit more and not be all the way white like that. So with the pit pens, I'm giving it a little shadow, and then I water it down so that it also have a bluish, very light bluish color over the text. And that is actually it. Just checking my girl for the last time, giving her some little more color. And then a little more shimmer. Made a spray myself with water and Nuvo. Nouveau mousse, so that's what I'm spraying here. to give it a little bit of extra shimmer, and that's all I did to my page. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you the next time. Bye.